my name is Leslie and I'm with Red River Paper. Today's video, we're going to be going over our sample kits, which is perfect if you are brand new to our website and trying to find the perfect paper for your printing project, or if you are just wanting to see what type of surface you might even like. We are going to start on the redriverpaper.com page. And between these two, you will click on the Premium Photo Inkjet Papers button. This will take you to all the inkjet photo papers. And the best place to start is our sample kit section. So at the top, it'll be right here on a desktop. If you're on a mobile device, there will be a little three line called the hamburger icon on the left that you can click on and see sample kits in there. Once you're in here, you have four different options of sample kits. We got photography, art and design, greeting and note cards, and scrapbooks. And so depending on the category you need, you will choose one of these. If you do any photography, a lot of photographers I know say they also do artwork or like fine art photography. This works for any form of photography, whether you're just doing portraits or weddings or fine art, landscapes, this will be your section here. This will be ideal if you are doing either graphic design, or if you are doing art reproductions or digital art. We have a lot more matte paper options. It's more matte focused in this one, whereas this one has a combination of matte, semi-gloss, gloss, metallic, and so on. So we'll start by looking in the photography section. And in here you have five kits. The photo base kit is ideal if you are just wanting the go-to selections, just the top most popular paper. It's one in each category. You have a metallic, you have a matte, you have a satin, and you have a gloss. The next section is if you want to go a little bit deeper and you want to try a few other options, we have from gloss, other matte options, some textured mattes, and so on. Then third one is for fine art photography. This one's really if you have a bigger printer, such as a 13-inch or wide one, because most of these papers will not feed in a front feed printer. So if you have a small all-in-one printer or anything that only has a front feed tray, these papers will not work in it. So it's ideal to have, like, whether you have an Epson SureColor or a Canon Pixma Pro printer, Pro 100, 200, 300, or 1000, so on. These papers will work in those printers. And this mostly it's cotton-based. Most of them also don't have optical brighteners. So if you want not just archival, but museum grade, majority of these papers are museum, or if they're not museum, then they're archival grade. The third kit is the lightweight papers. This is ideal for graphic design, or if you're wanting to do a zine, as many artists do, or a book and you want a lighter weight paper, or some if you're planning on printing on wide format rolls and you want a light matte or medium weight matte paper, 47-pound premium matte is very popular when it comes to rolls. Color jet, we have people using it for photo buttons or other projects where they want it's a little bit thicker and heavier than copy paper. So that's going to be the lightest weight paper we offer. And the next kit, the final one, is the double-sided papers kit, which, as it says, it's ideal if you want to do images on both sides of the paper, usually for books, portfolios, or just any project where you're wanting to do images on both sides. So we're going to go back to the sample kit section and look at the art and design. And like I said, the main difference is this one pretty much has more matte paper options. So the art go-to kit is there's only one satin, everything else is a matte finish, whether it's smooth or textured, it's all matte finish. So if you want to focus on that, this would be a good go-to. And this is our lighter weight cotton paper. So anybody who has, I would say, a Canon Pro 100 or any of the artisan printers, Epson artisans, or maybe if you have a smaller printer like the Canon TS series that can feed in the top, but you probably don't want to put too many heavy papers, this would be a good one to try if you want to try a fine art paper but just can't get those heavier options. So this is a great kit to start if you're doing art or just want to focus on matte papers. Again, the same fine art kit as the other one is here. If you have those bigger fine art printers, you want to try doing those. And then you have the lightweight kit again and the double-sided kit again. So then going back, the third section is the greeting and note cards. We have two kits here. The first one is the most popular go-to. Yet these two right here, the Polar Matte and the Pecos River Gloss, are the most popular best-selling options that we have. But we have many people like, if you want a texture, we got the canvas. Again, double-sided if you want to do images on the inside. The ones that are single-sided, just to let you know, have plain paper on the other side. So if they are marked as single-sided and they're greeting cards, it means they have a plain paper for the inside, so you can still write and print text if you wish. And then the expanded kit if you want to try some of the other unique options, the super heavyweight, the cotton, and so on. The last one is our scrapbook kit. This one's really, there's just one kit. It's all of our 12 by 12 paper. If you just want to be printing 12 by 12, that's the best option. Most people who do that are scrapbookers, but we do have artists who also want to do 12 by 12 the size or just try it out. So that's an option there if you want to try it. So that is all of our sample kits for you. I hope it helps narrow down the options. If you have any other questions, please call us at 888-248-8774 or email us at support@redriverpaper.com. Also, please remember to subscribe below and get more videos that will have printing tips and tutorials to help you along your printing journey. See you next time!